In the next few videos, we're going to talk about classes of operators that have some very nice properties. And these operators are usually defined by how they relate to their adjoints. So before we can talk about those operators, we have to talk about what adjoints are. So let's suppose that V is a vector space and it's got an inner product. And let's suppose we have an operator on that inner product. Then the adjoint of that operator is another operator which we denote L dagger. That's supposed to be a little dagger, which has the idea that if you apply L dagger to the left-hand factor of an inner product, it gives you the same result as applying L to the right-hand factor of the inner product. And this has to work for all vectors in our space. So for example, let's suppose that we're in R2 with the standard inner product. And let's suppose I give you an operator that takes a vector x1, x2, it promotes x2 to the first position, and it puts nothing in the second slot. Then I claim that L dagger does sort of the opposite. It pushes x1 down to the second position, and it puts nothing in the first slot. And to check that, we compare, we see what happens if you take x inner product with ly. Well, that's x1, x2 times y2, 0. That's x1 times y2. On the other hand, L dagger x inner product with y, L dagger x gives you 0, x1 times y1, y2. Well, that also gives you x1, y2. So these two things are equal. And since this works no matter what x is and no matter what y is, this is the adjoint of this operator. Okay, so that's the definition. So what? Well, let's figure out some properties of adjoints. The first is that they exist. Now, I say always, if you've got infinite dimensional vector spaces, there are some subtle issues about domains. We're not going to worry about them. Finite dimensions, they always exist. Infinite dimensions, they exist if you make your definitions correctly. The second is that the adjoint of the sum of two operators is just the adjoint of the first plus the adjoint of the second. The adjoint of a constant times an operator is not the constant times the adjoint. It's the complex conjugate of the constant times the second. The adjoint of a product of operators is the product of the adjoints in the opposite order. And finally, the adjoint of the adjoint is the operator itself. Now, you can prove these by sort of chasing, well, except for one. We're going to prove one later. You can prove two through five by definition chasing. I'm just going to prove four, and the others are proved in similar ways. So for four, we want to figure out what is it that when acting on x does the same as Lm acting on y. Well, Lm acting on y is the same thing as L acting on my. And by definition, L dagger acting on x inner product with my is the same thing as L acting on x inner product with L acting on my. L acting on the right is the same thing as L dagger acting on the left. And then we can move the m to the other side. M acting on L dagger x, sorry, M dagger acting on L dagger x has the same effect as M acting on y. So we get M dagger acting on L dagger x. And that's just M dagger L dagger acting on x. So M dagger L dagger acting on x gives you the same result as Lm acting on y. So the adjoint of Lm is M dagger L dagger. Okay, but how do you get them? Well, adjoints are actually very easy if we're working with Rn with a standard inner product. See, if you're working with Rn, then of course operators are nothing but n by n matrices. And I claim that the adjoint of an operator is just its transpose. You're familiar with the transpose. In fact, you can think of adjoints as in some sense a generalization of transposes. Why is that? Well, the inner product of x with ay, remember the inner product of two vectors, you take the transpose of the first and you multiply it by the second. So the inner product of x with ay is x transpose times ay. But you can think of that as x transpose a times y, and x transpose A is A transpose x transpose. And so this is the inner product of A transpose x with y. And one way to look at that is, see, here is y. And if you put this together, you get this is AY. And then you take the inner product of x with AY. That's all well and good. But you could just as well do this multiplication first. You can take the row that you get when you take, multiply this row by this matrix, and then multiply that by y. And this is a dagger x. And that inner product with y is the same thing as x inner product with ay. Whenever you have a row times a matrix times a column, you can think of it as a row times a matrix times a column, or you can think of it as a row times a matrix times a column. And if we go back to our original example, when we said L of x gives you x2, 0, that means the matrix of L is just 0, 1, 0, 0. Its adjoint was 0, 0, 1, 0. It was just its transpose. And L dagger of x1, x2 is 0, x1. Okay. That's Rn. What about Cn? If we have Cn with the standard inner product, well, the standard inner product for Cn is that the inner product of x with y is x transpose conjugate times y. So there's got to be a conjugacy in here. And in fact, the adjoint is the transpose conjugate. And the transpose conjugate of a matrix is sometimes called the Hermitian conjugate. So I claim that A dagger is A transpose conjugate. In other words, the ij entry of A dagger is the ji entry of A conjugated. Why? Well, the inner product of x with ay is x transpose conjugate times ay. You put the parentheses this way, and you say, well, that's x transpose A conjugate, conjugate y. So that's A conjugate transpose x transpose conjugate times y. And that's A transpose conjugate x times y. So for example, if you had an operator given by the matrix 1 plus I, 2 plus 3i, 3 minus 4i, 6i, you want to take its adjoint. You just take its transpose, the 3 minus 4i goes up here, and the 2 plus 3i goes down here. But then you have to conjugate things. Instead of 3 minus 4i, you get 3 plus 4i. Instead of 2 plus 3i, you get 2 minus 3i. Instead of 1 plus i, you get 1 minus i. Instead of 6i, you get minus 6i. Now we'll talk about adjoints in more complicated spaces in the next video.